I welcome you all, myself, Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande, would like to welcome you all in my YouTube channel Ayurveda Academy. Today, we will discuss about the edema, that is shoth in Sanskrit or in Hindi. Sujan aa jati hai. Kai kabar aankh ke baju mein sujan hoti hai, kai kabar pairon mein sujan hoti hai, कई कबार पूरे शरीर में भी सूजन हो सकती है. तो हमें देखना है कि ये सूजन आने की वजह क्या है. व्हाट इज द कॉज, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस फॉर द कंप्लेनिंग ऑफ इडिमा. तो दिस पर्टिकुलर इडिमा टॉपिक इज इन आयुर्वेदा इज मेंशन्ड एज अ शोथ टॉपिक एंड विच इज वेरी यूजफुल फॉर द रोग निदान सब्जेक्ट ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर BMS. एंड ऑल्सो दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर ऑल द मेडिकल प्रैक्टिशनर्स. They must be able to diagnose properly what is the exact cause of the edema, and then only they can be successful in treating that particular edema. Myself is Professor Dr. Deshpande. I am MD in Ayurvedic Medicine and MD in Ayurvedic Physiology. My WhatsApp number is 9226810630. Okay, this is the question that is asked in the Roga Nidana Vikruti Vijnana subject. Explain the causes, symptoms and differential diagnosis of edema. Shoth vyadhi vyavachheda likhkar karan lakshan likhiye. So, what is the edema? What is the definition? Excessive accumulation of the fluid in an interstitial space. You know, the intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid. So the fluid in between the two cells is called as a interstitial space. And when the fluid is accumulated excessively, that is called as an edema. Edema can be localized at particular region, or it can be full body. Total full body is edematous. So when the full body is edematous, swelling is there, generalized form of edema is called as anasarca. Can you see my cursor? Anasarca. Don't forget, generalized body edema. So there are four types of pressures which contribute in the exchange of fluid. You know, the arteries, the blood is circulated from arteries, arterioles, capillaries, venules, veins, inferior, superior vena cava. This is the blood circulation. Okay, so actually for the oxygenation purpose, for the nutritional purpose, the capillary is secreting some material into the interstitial space, and from there the cells are taking in the nutrients and oxygens. So whenever this process is going on of exchange of fluid, waste product is coming into the venules. So this exchange, there is some pressure in the capillaries. The hydrostatic pressure of the plasma, hydrostatic pressure of the plasma that is in the blood, and interstitial oncotic pressure, remember these words for the pathology, are responsible for the net outward flow of the fluid. Are you getting my point? Two types of pressures are there: hydrostatic pressure of the plasma and interstitial oncotic pressure. Both are responsible for exchange of fluids. The interstitial hydrostatic pressure and plasma oncotic pressure lead the inward direction of the fluid. Interstitial hydrostatic pressure, okay, and plasma oncotic pressure lead the inward direction of the fluid. In the formation of the edema, in spite of coming to the capillaries, the outward directional pressures from capillary to the interstitial fluid, from capillaries to the interstitial fluid, this pressure is more. So the fluid is coming from the capillaries into the interstitial fluid. Okay, so unilateral on the only one side, localized edema. What are the four reasons? Don't forget: cellulitis, deep vein thrombosis (DVT), filariasis, and gout. These are the causes for localized unilateral edema: cellulitis, DVT, filariasis, and gout. What is cellulitis? Inflammation of the tissue. That particular affected your thigh or the arm shows the signs of inflammation. For example, swelling will be there, red color will be there, raised local temperature and pain will be there. So these are the features of inflammation, and affected parts show tenderness. In Ayurveda, it is called as a sparsha sahatva. When you try to touch that particular part, the patient will grumble. He will be getting pain when you try to touch that particular part. That is called as a tenderness. Okay. So this is a case of cellulitis on the the leg region. Now next, deep vein thrombosis. There will be swelling in the calf muscle. With signs of inflammation, this is typical feature of deep vein thrombosis. Okay, calf tenderness. Again, the same thing. When you try to touch the calf, patient will grumble. He will cry. He will shout because he is getting the pain by touching. So that is calf tenderness is a typical feature of deep VT. Here, the most danger part in this disease, fear of embolism. So if you press that particular organ, if my calf is paining, so somebody is pressing, patient take the massages, and this should not be done. Remember my words. In deep vein thrombosis, calf massage should not be done, because otherwise there is a fear of pulmonary embolism and death. Some emboli, moving clot, will escape from that particular region, from the deep vein thrombosis, and that will stuck up into the pulmonary arteries, and that can be the pulmonary embolism, and the patient can die immediately because of the respiratory arrest, pulmonary edema. See, calf pain, can you see over here? So defective valve. What is the reason for deep vein? The impure blood is not going properly up. Okay, so this is a normal flow, but here you can see that particular valves are defective, and so the blood is clotting over there. So this is a DVT, deep vein thrombosis, normal anatomy. And this is the deep vein thrombosis. You can see the cellulitis, calf swelling is there, erythema is there, and leg warmth is there. So all are indicating the patient may have these veins as well as the inflammation. So deep vein thrombosis will be there. Next cause is filariasis. It is also called as elephantiasis. The edema is initially pitting. What is pitting? When you press, there is a dig. So it will be go inside. That is a pitting. But later on, it becomes the non-pitting edema due to the fibrosis. To begin with, is a lymphatic obstruction. So naturally, pitting edema will be there. When you press over there, there will be a dig. Concavity will come. But afterward, when fibrosis develops, there will be non-pitting edema. These are the two varieties, pitting edema, non-pitting edema. So filariasis is characterized by intermittent fever, especially this fever comes at night. So can you see elephantiasis? Legs are looking like elephant leg. So this is called as elephantiasis. Gout. This is an inflammatory condition secondarily to raised level of serum uric acid. Problem is with the uric acid metabolism. Your serum uric acid, you have to test the blood. It's a type of arthritis. The inflammatory response is very common behind the great toe. The disease starts at the great toe. That part becomes red and tender. Can you see over here? This is gout. And here you can see uric acid crystals, masses of uric acid, tophi. Swollen and inflamed joint. This joint is inflamed. This is called as gout type of arthritis. Now I am talking about generalized edema. Whole body is affected with the swelling and edema. What are the causes? Heart diseases like congestive cardiac failure. You have to do the ECG, 2D echo, etc., etc. Nephrotic syndrome, kidney problem, liver disorders like cirrhosis of the liver, portal hypertension will be there, hypothyroidism, myxedema, and anemia due to the hypoproteinemia. Proteins become less in the body and you get the anemic condition and you get the generalized edema. So here you can see pedal edema here. Swelling is over here. This pedal edema and ascites, fluid in the peritoneal cavity, these two things suggest either there may be problem in the liver or in the heart. very common in the congestive cardiac failure, that is the right atrial failure. Okay. Now, another list of causes: anemia with hypoproteinemia, as I already mentioned, drug-induced edema. Sometimes some drugs, medicines can cause side effects. Venous insufficiency, inferior vena cava, venous drain, impure blood is not coming in the heart. It is stagnant at the lower part of your body and you get the edema. Angioneurotic edema is like allergy. Angioneurotic edema means allergic edema. Mixed edema, that is thyroid function is less. Hypothyroidism, you have to test the blood, T3, T4, TSH. Then premenstrual edema. Before starting the menses, monthly cycle, the ladies get the premens because of the salt retention. Okay. So here you can see nephrotic edema, kidney problem, always around the eyes. Kidney swelling, kidney edema, always periorbital swelling. Can you see periorbital swelling? Mixed edema, whole face is swollen. Not only eyes, whole face, that is mixed edema, hypothyroidism. Anemia with hypoproteinemia. In this condition, the edema is common in areolar tissue, that is periorbital and the pedal edema, both. The patient is having pallor. You can see the eyes, you can see the nails, the extremities are cold and complaints of recurrent stomatitis. So you must do the hemoglobin test. Hemogram, RBC, hemoglobin will be definitely less than 8 g/cent or 10 g/cent. Normal hemoglobin, 12 to 14 g/cent. Drug-induced edema, sudden onset, allergy, swelling of the face and feet. Try to find out whether there the patient is taking steroids for kidney problem, for rheumatoid arthritis problem. Why so long a tablet? Prednisolone on a tablet. That can cause overdose. Consecutive many months the patient is taking, the patient will suffer from Cushing's syndrome. Side effect of the drug like NSAIDs, steroid, then that is called as a Cushing syndrome, moon-shaped face, round and swollen face, moon-shaped face. This is specialty of Cushing syndrome. Some drugs like Voveron, Brufen, Ibuprofen, Combiflam, this can cause side effect as a edema. If the woman is taking oral contraceptive pills, that is Mala D tablets, OC pills also can cause water retention and edema. See, you can see the steroid Cushing syndrome, moon-shaped face, like the moon, moon-shaped circular face. Venous is insufficiency. It is very common in the middle-aged woman at the age of 35-40, typically appears on the ankle region because the impure blood is not going up, valves are defective, and the blood is remaining due to the gravity at the pedal area. So ankle swelling is more common. Angioneurotic or allergic edema. It is the type of hypersensitivity reaction to the allergen. It releases the mast cell secretions, that is histamine. That's why the doctors give the antihistaminic, anti-allergic tablet, NSAID L. Relent tablet, R-E-L-E-N-T, Relent. So this is antihistaminic. Due to the histamine, the itching takes place. Most typical of allergy is always itching. Itching in the practice is common in two conditions. Remember, whenever, wherever itching, number one, allergy, and number two, fungal infection. Allergy and fungal infection can cause itching, pruritus. Okay. The other symptoms of allergic reactions are edema, rash, dyspnea, breathlessness, and hoarseness of voice. Voice will change. Hoarseness of voice, typical laryngeal edema. This is a danger sign. Laryngeal edema suggests that the patient is having allergic type of edema. Can you see the lips are how they are swollen? The child may be eating peanuts, mungfali, ground nuts. He may be eating egg. He may be eating some allergic food. That's why immediately the lips are swollen. Next, mixed edema or hypothyroidism. Low level of thyroid hormones, T3 and T4 in the plasma reduces the basal metabolic rate. Secondary to this basal metabolic rate, the water retention takes place in the body. Patient complains heaviness in the body, lethargy, tired, lack of confidence, bradycardia, and puffiness. Premenstrual edema. Due to the retention of water and sodium, the edema develops in premenstrual syndrome. Many times, diuretics can give as a symptomatic relief because there is a water accumulation, and what you have to give? Tablet Lasix or injection Lasix. The best drug in Ayurveda for edema, for shoth is, write down, Punarnava. In the market, Punarnava Ghanavati available. Punarnava Ghanavati available. Punarnava Ghanavati, 2 tablets, 3 times in a day, you can take for reducing any type of the edema as a symptomatic relief. It's not a basic relief, symptomatic relief. So, my dear friend, this is all, but remember, I am doing all these videos as a educational videos. So don't do any medication as a self-medication if you are patient. You must consult your family physician or any concerned doctor and then take any medicines, maybe Lasix, maybe Visolon, maybe Punarnava, any medicine you have to take after physician consultation. So you can WhatsApp me on 922-681-0630 for PPT, paid PPT as per demand, paid audios, paid videos I can prepare for yourself because after payment at the 922-681-0630. So I wish, thank you very much for your kind cooperation. I request all of you to like this video, share this video, and please subscribe my YouTube channel to boost my energy, because I am preparing the videos from first year to last year BMS students, as well as Ayurvedic doctors, Ayurvedic teachers, and also for the patients. So I am thankful and I wish all the best. Please take care, good care of yourself. All the best. Thank you very much.